Hi there, Lindsay here, the Frugal Crafter. Today I want to talk about something that I think has gone through every one of our minds every time we're painting something or creating anything for that matter, and that is the what if I ruin it phase. Now, this is different than the popular hot mess phase, which is when you make a big old mess pretty early on in the painting and you don't know what's going to happen, but you push through and you make it work, right? Well, the what if I ruin it phase is when you're not sure if it's done. It's looking pretty good and you don't really want to risk anything. So you can do a couple things. You can forge ahead anyway, potentially risking it, or potentially making it totally awesome, or you can be like, that's it, I'm done. I'm not gonna touch it because I don't wanna ruin it. And you can let it sit. So if you decide to go that way and you let it sit and you come back the next day, you may see exactly what the painting needs, or you may decide that it's fine the way it is. You may just look at it in a mirror and kind of get a fresh perspective that way, and you'll be able to tell if there's anything wrong with it or it needs to be fixed. And that's not exactly what I'm talking about here today. What I'm talking about is that point when you have fear. You have fear that you're going to ruin something that you have spent some time on. And I want to urge you, now so you'll know if it's absolutely the best it can be. You'll have a certain feeling of serene knowledge that, yep, this is it, this is as good as it's going to be, I've surpassed anything I've done before, and this is done. But if you're not feeling like that, if you're not feeling completely confident that it is done and it's the best of your ability, then what I want you to do is push through the fear and try whatever it is on your mind that you think might just improve it. Yeah, you might ruin it, but you know what? If you ruin it, you're gonna learn something, and that's gonna make you a better artist. The breakthrough is in the fear. You have to go through the fear to make the breakthroughs in your art. If you play it safe, you may create beautiful painting after beautiful painting, but they won't be outstanding or the best that you can do. So you owe it to yourself to push through the fear and see how far you can take that painting. I really think that there's no room for fear in art. Art is the only place you have total control. Any other aspect of your world, you have to get along with people. You have to play by the rules. You have to observe certain, you know, rules of society, and you don't want to take any big risks that could have big consequences. You're not going to have in your art journal or on your canvas or on your greeting card or on your scrapbook layout. There's no big consequences there, so you might as well push through and try. Because if you don't try, you're going to get very bored with your hobby or your art career for that matter. You're going to get stale, you're going to get burned out, and you're going to get bored. All run into that. I ran into that quite recently. I was feeling very burnt out, and it occurred to me that I was doing the same thing over and over again. I was doing what was safe. For me, it was live streaming, and the projects I did live streaming were very safe projects. I knew what the results would be. I didn't have much room to chance. And yeah, you know, you come up with little mishaps along the way, and you work through them and you fix them as you go. But I wasn't doing anything really risky because I didn't want to waste time. I didn't want to waste my time. I didn't want to waste your time. I didn't want to have a big mess for the whole world to see live. So I played it really safe. And then after a while, that really just took its toll on me. I wasn't doing enough work on my own for my own progress to grow as an artist, to really push me. We all owe that to ourselves if we're trying to grow as painters. I think in any sort of creative hobby, you need to push past that fear to see how far you can go. I think if you are a fashion designer, I think if you are an interior designer, probably if you build houses, whatever it is, you have to push your limits and you have to push through that fear, because on the other side of the fear is where the breakthroughs lie. So the next time you're painting, I want you to remember that. It's only a piece of paper. It's only a canvas. Worst comes to worst, you regesso that sucker and you start again. It's not the end of the world. Worst comes to worst with your watercolor painting, if you mess it up, you can always put a watercolor ground on it. You can always add some mixed media or collage to it. But you will be pushing past that fear. The minute you're too afraid to do something to your painting because you're afraid you're going to ruin it, and of course, I'm not saying this if you're doing like a commercial project for somebody or you're doing a commission, obviously, you know, you're not the end user for that art, but if you are creating something because you're passionate about creating it, it's only for you, then push through the fear and create something amazing. I also want to mention, if you do need any help in that department, you need any critique or anybody to hold you accountable to create more art and push through the fear, and you want to share that art with a very supportive, caring, closed group, please check out my critique club. I will link that below. It's a nice group of a bunch of us over on Teachable, and we share our artwork, and there are two real-time lessons, and actually I put my sketchbook Sunday lessons there, a couple of them a month, where I narrate everything. So I started doing sketchbook Sunday because I felt like I wasn't pushing myself, and I wanted to do something that I didn't have a predictable outcome. I didn't have a predictable result. So that's why I always put up as time lapses, because I was just kind of rolling with it. A lot of times I was listening to podcasts and I was just focusing on the art and not trying to talk at the same time. And so I really found that I pushed myself, I pushed my skills, and I really enjoyed that. And that fed that artistic part of my soul that I felt had kind of been neglected when I was doing artwork with just very predictable outcomes. So you owe it to yourself to push yourself in your art, push past the fear, and see what you have inside of you. See what you have to give and see what your potential is. Your potential is beyond the fear. Your potential is not right here. Your potential is past the fear. So so go make some scary art today, I guess. I want to thank you so much for watching. You can let me know what you think in the comments below. How do you push past creative block? What do you do when you're at that point of, what if I ruin it? Do you maybe work with a smaller brush so you can't make too big of a mistake? Do you let it sit for a bit? Let us know in the comments below, because I think it's nice to see how we all deal with these creative challenges. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Until then, happy crafting.